the condition of the prison in Phillipsburg, I understand it's really, really horrible.
Well, I think you're familiar with the Corallo report.
Yeah.
Well, they call it torture, the circumstances. Well, that was in the police station in town. Mm-hmm. You have shit on the wall, sorry for my French. And it happens, cells can be crowded, that perfectly normal guys, maybe they did beat their girlfriend, I'm not gonna condone that, but they're not crazy people. Or a young guy, doing a little burglary, not good, but they are being locked up with a lunatic, with a person with very serious psychiatric problems who could be a danger to them. And I don't think that's very very healthy situation. I think they have to make sure that people will be selected who can be together with each other. Some people you better detain alone. Mm. And Point Blanc's prison, yeah, it's dangerous. You have gangs out there, and they try to settle scores. So sometimes they have to move people from one alley to the next, but then there's another guy with whom they have problems, and there it's the same. It's filthy, no good ventilation. It's cramped up. And if you put people in a place like that, they're already in a nasty situation. It only makes, the way of thinking of those guys worse. I mean, if you're in a horrible, filthy environment, it's gonna make you more depressed and probably more aggressive.
So it's not good. It's counterproductive.
No, absolutely.
When people follow what's happening right now, the criminal cases, and then there are also cases that involve politicians, and then they will hear that they're arrested, and then it's 8 days, and 8 days, and then 60 days.
Yeah.
All of that is legal.
It's legal. Like, the maximum period somebody can be put in what they call pretrial detention is 116 days, so almost 4 months. And then, the prosecutor would have to start a trial. Mm-hmm. Then they bring the person to the court, and publicly they will read out what a person has been indicted with, what the accusations are, and then the judge who is leading the trial, who is presiding the trial, can decide to keep the person still in custody.
Still after all those days?
Yeah. Basically, that's really outrageous. Pre-trial detention before the European court would call it undue delay. The time frame is 2 years. So it's very complicated. I have a lady right now. Mm-hmm. She's going to be trialed next week. She is already 27 months in pre-trial detention.
27 months?
Yes.
In St. Martin?
In St. Martin. But we're talking there about a double homicide case.
Wow.
And it's a complicated case with one suspect that was flown out to Holland after Hurricane Irma. So circumstances are a little, exceptional. Mm. Still, I think things could have been dealt with way faster. So it is a reason why I'm going to complain about this too.
But I mean, 27 months,
yeah.
that's more than 2 years.
Yeah, it is. February 2017, she got arrested.
Yeah. So all that time, she's sitting in prison.
Yes, correct.
So now you said next week you're going to court.
This is a trial, finally. Yes.
But then, one is detained in the Netherlands. That's going to be done via
video conference. Yes.